I'm Patrick Dykstra, ocean explorer.
There it is, right here.
Adventurer. As a human being, getting close to something so massive, one of the biggest animals to ever inhabit the planet, it's an addictive feeling. But this is an apex predator, and it feeds on giant squid. The sperm whale is the quintessential whale. That's Moby Dick. They're absolutely massive, up to 65 feet long, and weighing up to 50 tons. Yet we know almost nothing about them. They live in complex societies, family units that we have very little understanding of, and they communicate over vast distances of ocean. They have the biggest brain of any animal on Earth.
And you can really see that intelligence, that this is not just an animal that's relying on instinct and its incredible sensory ability. It's actually thinking.
We know they're hunting because they come back up often with squid tentacles dangling out of their mouths and scars from where the squid have tried to attack them.
They're going down and engaging in these colossal battles with squid. And we have only brief glimpses of what it could be like. It's just completely out of human reach. I would be crushed by the pressure.
So I wonder now, it looks like it's gone a bit soft. I wonder if the pressure has maybe done something to our camera.
Oh, here's a creek. So this would be right before.
Oh,
head jerk!
Dominica is a remote volcanic island in the Eastern Caribbean. It's the best place in the world to find sperm whales. Even though there are lots of sperm whales in these waters, they can travel hundreds of miles in any direction. But there's a simple, very effective tool to narrow down my search.
Okay.
The hydrophone. It's an audio device that can be used underwater to pick up sperm whale vocalizations for miles around.
When they're down at depth hunting for squid, they make a sound, tick, 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 tick. They use their nostril to make this sound, and we can hear it on the hydrophone. Hear that? Tick, 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 tick. Yeah, it's encouraging to put that hydrophone in and immediately hear what sounds like bacon frying or popcorn popping, this tick, 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 tick. When they hunt squid down there, there's a pickup in pace of that sound right before they hit the squid. Tick, tick, tick. But now it's just a matter of really keeping all our eyes on the seas.
Yeah, there, look.
Just here. 2 o'clock to the boat, 2 sperm whales just surfaced.
Swimming down towards us.
We're okay here.
Go ahead.
Despite their massive size, sperm whales are surprisingly fast, and they're surprisingly sensitive. So I have to cover a large distance across the surface of the ocean to get close to them. I can't take heavy scuba equipment with me, so the only way I'm going to get close to them is to free dive. By freediving, I'm faster and I'm quieter.
It's interesting to see how wrinkled they are when their lungs are empty. And then they take a big breath and a lot of those wrinkles go away as they expand and fill with air right before they dive to go forage.
So amazing to see, but such a brief time, just not staying on the surface very long.
There are other animals in the area. Pilot whales. These predatory pack hunters patrol the oceans in large pods. They compete with sperm whales for food. They've been known to harass them by leaving bite marks on their tails. Their presence here doesn't bode well.
Breach!
There it is.
Really big group of pilot whales, but they've just been harassing a young sperm whale, so they may do it again.
Breach!
The sperm whale dives.
No. You don't hear anything. Very quiet.
So when there's no clicking, they're either not here, or potentially they're in stealth mode because there's blackfish around and they don't want to make clicks to give off their location.
We head out to the coordinates where they were last seen. Then, 30 feet down, I see something straight out of a science fiction movie. They're like alien egg sacs floating just under the surface of the sea. This is how sperm whales sleep. Sperm whales have the shortest sleep cycle of any mammal on Earth, remaining in this stasis for around 15 minutes at a time. They have to hunt often. They consume around 2,000 pounds of squid every day. So they've perfected power napping at the surface.
There was a calf in there. It was not quite as good as the adults at controlling its buoyancy. So it would go down and try to sleep vertically like the rest of them. So you would see it curve a little bit sideways and then expel some air, try to be vertical again, and then float up. It was really cute, and the adults were keeping an eye on that little calf, trying to sleep the same way that they sleep.
One by one, these sleeping giants awake from their slumber. I slide in, and this time, they don't seem spooked by me. They allow me to stay with them. A young calf lets its curiosity get the better of it, and it comes over to check me out, completely unafraid. This is the unit I've been waiting for. But nothing could prepare me for what happens next. There's a moment when an animal so massive is coming directly towards you. It certainly crosses my mind that something could happen. As she's coming over, she's tilting her head up to point her lower jaw, the bottom of her mouth at me, scanning my body. It's like she's seeing inside me with those sonar pulses. My heart, my lungs, my kidneys. But then it becomes much more rapid. You can hear that sound gaining pace. This is how she hunts for squid.